you spent last year with Tampa. Did you get a sense that the team was kicking tires on somebody other than Jameis at the end of the season in the manner that we're learning that they were already evaluating other quarterbacks elsewhere? Did you get that sense?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. What I saw last year, the team started off, I got there, I think the team was 1-6, 1-7 at the time. I got there week 8. We ended up winning, I think, 7 out of our last 9 games, which was positive. But you could tell the team was kind of saying, we need something or someone to help us get over this hump. And obviously the first position you look at is the quarterback. And so I did get that sense that, man, yes, Jameis played really, really well, but the team, you know, Jason Light, the GM, whether it was BA, even defensive, on the defensive side with Todd Bowles, it's like, hey, we need somebody, right? Maybe it's quarterback, maybe it's tight end, maybe it's some guys on the defensive side of the ball to really help us get over that hump. Because anybody who knows BA is a winner. He doesn't play around, right? He's a winner, right? One of the biggest things I remember playing with them in Tampa Bay and also in Arizona when I played with them in Arizona, right? You start stacking those wins, 1 in a row, 2 in a row, 3 in a row, right? This idea of momentum, we see it. You know, when he says, you know, they remember what you do in December, right? Playoff teams, right? It's momentum. And so anyways, to answer your question, I did get a sense that the team was ready to go in a different direction. I didn't know it was going to be Tom Brady. And I think the jury's still out on seeing how that marriage is going to work out with B.A. and his mind about throwing it deep 7 to 9 times a game. And Tom Brady, in a lot of ways, the check down king. We're still going to see how that's going to work out. But I did get a sense that Tampa Bay is trying to win and trying to win now.
Sam, do you want to do this for a living, like analysis? Like, is that something that you'd be interested in or no?
I know I'm good at it, Rich, but I don't know if I want to do it for a living. I mean, I enjoy it, and I've been doing a little bit of it, and I enjoy it. And I think what I can provide is, like, the athlete perspective, right? Because I feel like it's so easy to, like, look, Mr. Trubisky. Everybody gets on Mr. Trubisky. Oh, man, bench the guy, this and that. It's like, no, it's so much deeper than that, right? People are getting on Le'Veon Bell, right? Jamal Adams. They're saying these guys are, you know, some people have said they're cancers. And it's like, dude, hold on. If you got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 players saying the same thing, I'm not just saying about Adam Gase, right? It happens from team to team. It's like maybe you should look at it from a player's perspective. And so anyways, yeah, this is some stuff I really enjoy doing, talking ball, encouraging people, and just kind of giving people a different mindset, a different point of view than what you usually hear.
You like that video? Of course you did. Check out more right here.